To actually see success in young people, to me, is the most exciting thing about the work.
When I'm talking to my students and I can see a light bulb go off, when I see them make connections.
When we see our students graduate and get jobs in the major corporations around the country or local companies, or maybe they get out and start their own company, then this is really the best measure of our success.
It really is the energy I get from my undergraduates. If I see them succeeding, if I see them sort of opening their mind to new thoughts, new ideas, then I think I've succeeded.
There is a unique measuring stick when it comes to education. Your true success is judged not by what you accomplish, but by the accomplishments of others, those you teach, inspire, and transform. For more than 200 years, our success has been measured in knowledge imparted, minds prepared, leaders produced. This is the College of Arts and Sciences of the University of South Carolina.
Prize-winning scientists have trained here, phenomenal artists and people who enrich the culture not only of the state of South Carolina but the nation and the world have trained here. Important political figures, both of the state and of the United States, have graduated from this College of Arts and Sciences. And so I believe that their impact goes beyond the sheer number. I think the work that the alumni have gone on to do is simply first rate.
This success comes from an impressive array of intellectual pursuits and fields of study, including 24 academic programs, 19 departments, 15 centers, 10 institutes, and 125 degree programs.
We are nationally recognized for the work that we do in chemistry and biology, in the natural sciences. We are nationally recognized for the work that we do in history and in literature. And we are nationally recognized for the work that we do in the creative arts across two or three of our major programs. People around the country look to us as models for how we teach and how we do research, and how we involve students in those enterprises.
You don't have to look far to find graduates of the College of Arts and Sciences who are making a mark in society. Examples are plentiful, like Fran Persson, a 2005 Phi Beta Kappa graduate with a double major in political science and international studies. An outstanding football player and student leader, Fran is now the executive assistant to Vice President Joe Biden.
At the University of South Carolina, the College of Arts and Sciences has done so much for me and has really molded me and allowed me to be where I'm at today.
The teachers at the University of South Carolina, you know, what they taught you is how to be creative, how to think out of the box. Those are the types of skills that have really provided me an avenue of success in the job I have, because of the tools, because of the skills, because of the experiences that South Carolina instilled in me.
Janine Davidson, a PhD graduate in international studies, a C-17 pilot for the United States Air Force, and currently a Deputy Assistant Secretary of Defense working at the Pentagon.
What I do today, so much is about solving problems or trying to come up with solutions to problems. And I think that the education that I got at South Carolina made it so clear that there are just so many different ways to look at a problem, and that different people are going to bring different perspectives to that problem-solving space. I'm in Washington, and so oftentimes I'm the only one in the room who's not one of the Ivy League types. And I don't feel one bit as though that education was lesser than theirs. And in some cases, like I said, you know, the things that we were required to read, the breadth of the education, I think was at least definitely on par. And I think that people see that.
Peter McCausland, founder and CEO of Airgas, a $4 billion corporation. Peter graduated in 1971 with a bachelor's degree in history.
The teachers at Carolina instilled in me the ability to question things And I'm not a rebel by any stretch of the imagination, but I think that because I do question things and try to understand why things happen or and why people do certain things, I've been able to be more creative than some other people might be.
United States Senator Lindsey Graham, first elected to the Senate in 2002, after serving in the House of Representatives and as an attorney on active duty in the United States Air Force for more than 6 years.
I think it's a confidence building exercise. You go in wondering if you can make it, and you come out thinking you can do almost anything. And the degree at Carolina has served me well. I'm proud of the school, and I owe a lot to the University of South Carolina.
Dr. Honoree Monteith Treadwell currently serves as Associate Director of Development in the National Center for Primary Care at Morehouse School of Medicine. Dr. Treadwell served for 16 years as Program Director at the W.K. Kellogg Foundation. In 1963, she was the first African-American woman to enroll at the University of South Carolina.
The university allowed me to develop an independence. I felt safe, and I felt able to do what I wanted to do. And I think that that's something that I carry today. There needs to be some sense of safety, but also freedom to act, freedom to walk the path that you choose. And I don't know that I would have come to that place without being at the university. Did I get a good education? I did. I am so proud of what that institution gave to me and gives to so many others. And I hope that in some ways I can give back.
Successful graduates are a direct result of one of the most qualified faculties in the nation. More than 800 creative and dedicated teachers of young people who are leaders in professional associations and scholarly academies. A faculty that in the last academic year was awarded 38 grants, totaling more than $46 million in cutting-edge research projects, competing with prestigious universities across the nation. But that is only half the story.
Well, one of the things that's very special about the College of Arts and Sciences and about the faculty and staff that we have is they manage to pair first-class educational experiences with a real concern for students. And there's a palpable sense of community here that I think you don't find in so many other places. A sense of real concern for students. When I've recruited faculty who have had careers at other institutions, it's one of the first things they notice, that people can manage to be experts in their field, but still very caring toward students.
It's an approach to education that is not going unnoticed. Dean Fitzpatrick was recently elected the president of the Council of Colleges of Arts and Sciences. The reputation for excellence continues to grow.
I'm glad that Carolina is getting the recognition now that it has deserved for many, many years. People come up to me now and say, you know, I understand you went to the University of South Carolina. That is such an amazing school. My nephew's going there, or my son hopes to go there. And so, you know, for me, that's very rewarding. It's an amazing place. And I think the best is yet to come for Carolina.
There's a real vision at the University of South Carolina to be relevant in the 21st century. So I think the best days lie ahead for the Gamecocks academically and in sports.
And as I go to the university now and listen to the lectures with faculty and interact with students, it's one of the best kept secrets in the world, and that's a shame because it's outstanding in quality. We could not do better. And I want people to know the story and to go and to be on that beautiful campus and see the rich diversity of that campus. It's an outstanding institution. One would never have thought that that little institution that I went to many years ago would have grown into such a powerhouse, but it is. And I have been around the world. I have seen other institutions. I do know of what I speak. It's a treasure.
From a storied history of success to a future uniquely poised to impact the fabric of our society. Standing firmly at the intersection of the humanities and science, the epicenter of innovation for our modern world. This is the College of Arts and Sciences of the University of South Carolina.